From its origin in the Rwenzori Mountains, the river flows 250 kilometers through Kabarore, Fort Poto, Kamwenge, and Chenjojo districts before reaching Lake George. During their visit today, officials from the Ministry of Water and Environment noted that the heavy degradation of the river is threatening it. They have called on all stakeholders to save River Mpanga.
We are having people cultivating up the riverbank. And actually this causes a lot of siltation of the water system. When it rains, there's a lot of siltation of the river system, and water will actually, it won't be in a better quality. Because River Mpanga supplies more than 4 million people. Serves more than 4 million people. So national water actually depends on River Mpanga as the only source of water, for example, for Poto City.
Dr. Emmanuel Guma Bryan from the Ministry of Water and Environment has pointed out poor agriculture practices and sand mining at the upstream of the river as some of the activities threatening River Mpanga. Guma has condemned the increasing water pollution.
What we call point source pollution points, whereby most of the restaurants within the urban setup discharge directly into the river system. This creates a lot of point source pollution areas. We are having even washing bays that wash directly into the river system. So we are having so many issues that are affecting water resources within the Mpanga catchment, as well as increasing demand. The population is increasing and the demand for water is actually also increasing. So we're having a lot of demand, we're having pollution, we're having poor land management practices. All these are impacting on the water resources within the Mpanga catchment.
National Water and Sewage Corporation has over 10,000 water connections in Fort Poto town. However, consumers sometimes complain of the dirty brown water, especially during the rainy season due to contamination of the upstream.
I therefore invite all people of goodwill, the government of Uganda, the local population, to work with us to ensure that this catchment is duly protected upstream, where people are taught the better methods of farming, so that people are given alternative sources of livelihood, so that they don't go in to destroy the river. Midstream, the activities that we do, like afforestation and the rest, should be those that can promote and conserve the water, purify so that it is good for human consumption.
As a measure of tackling the problem at hand, the Minister of Water and Environment has today organized a marathon in Fort Poto as one of the ways of sensitizing the public on the dangers of degrading water systems in the country.
As chair of Mpanga Catchment Management, we remain committed and we join the rest of the teams, the Minister of Water, Toro Kingdom and all other partners in the conservation of this river, in the restoration of this river to its original shape, so that it can continue to serve the purpose for which God gave it us for.
In 2019, Toro Kingdom launched the campaign dubbed Save River Mpanga, with the king expressing fear that the river was being eaten away due to human activities. The campaign involved cleaning up activities to physically removing plastic wastes from River Mpanga and mobilizing as well as sensitizing the community about the dangers of irresponsible waste management. Mugume Vincent, the Toro Kingdom Deputy Minister of Information, called for an end to the degradation taking place at the river, emphasizing on the need by the kingdom's subjects to embrace the king's message of conserving the environment.
My appeal to the people of Toro and Uganda at large is to conserve the environment and also to plant friendly trees to this environment.
Those who took part in the exercise have explained their role in conserving nature.
We need to save that river. It has to have clean water, because where it flows, some people use this water for drinking, for washing, for cooking. So as a health personnel, we have to take part in this, because water is healthy.
Mpanga is a must, especially if we are looking at development. We must save River Mpanga. That's a must. It's everyone's responsibility to save this river. It's upon me. We must save it for the future generations.
Report compiled by Jonathan Tusingwire for the news.